Hi, this is Kurt at Traverse Tool Company. Today we're going to talk about power drills and how to use them. A power drill is one of those tools that you might think is only going to be used for those serious DIY projects. Actually though, it's something that every homeowner or even a renter should have on hand. In my personal opinion, things that you might want to look for when you're shopping for a drill are, should I go with electric or cordless? In my opinion, cut the leash, set yourself free, and go with the cordless. When you're shopping for a new drill, I would recommend getting one with two batteries. That way, when you're using one battery, the other one can be charging. The most common chuck size is half inch, which is my personal favorite. The reason I prefer the half inch over the 3/8 is because it holds a lot more tools that go into the chuck. You can get it with a larger chuck if you need it that big, but the price jumps substantially. Now that we have one, let's take a look at our new drill. Most of them operate the same way regardless of brand. The chuck is where you insert the tool into. You spin the chuck and it opens up. If you want, you can speed that up by pulling the trigger. Insert your tool into it and tighten it, and you're ready to roll. The trigger on these drills is a variable speed. When you pull it in just a little bit, you can see it turning slowly. The more you pull it in, the faster it turns. Any drill is going to have forward and reverse on it. That's usually a switch. In this case, it's right up here. So as you push it in on one side, it spins backwards. Push it in the other side, it spins forward, or put it right in the middle, and that trigger doesn't pull at all, so that's a safety. Most drills also come with variable speeds. This one is set to the high speed, which is number 2. Move that over to 1, and that's the low speed. That's in 1. That's in two, you can see the difference at full trigger pull, at full speed. So the last thing we're going to talk about is the torque control. This is currently set to drill. That's what that little mark on there resembles. The next thing is the torque setting. This particular drill goes up to 15, which is the highest torque. And you can go down to number 1, which is the lowest torque. And we'll talk a little bit more about that later. Now we're going to see how much easier it is to drive a screw in a piece of wood with a power drill as compared to a screwdriver. So here's just using a screwdriver, running it in there. Whoops, yeah, that always happens, but let's try it again. Ah, I'll get it. Okay, I got it. Getting harder. So for the sake of saving time, let's just go straight to the power drill. There it is. And I don't want this one in here anymore, so I can take it right out. We started out pretty easy by using a Phillips head screw. Now we're going to go to a screw that uses a flat blade screwdriver. These are absolutely miserable, as you can see, compared to Phillips screws. All right, I'm done trying. Let's just go straight to our hand drill. Still not the easiest, but so much easier than the old conventional screwdriver. Once you have your new power drill, you're going to find so many different uses around the house for it. Thank you for watching this video. I hope that it clarified some things for you. If you still have any questions, feel free to give us a call, send us an email, and check out our solutions page.